Hello everybody, in this video, you're gonna learn my favorite method to make organic illustrations. A technique I haven't seen being used too much, but that I've been using for years. We're gonna make these three ghosts, keeping with the theme of the season, entirely in Inkscape, step by step and in real time. It's a perfect tutorial for beginners to learn the basics of making these type of shapes and get to practice the basics. All you need to take this lesson is some basic knowledge of the program. My full introduction to Inkscape should be more than enough, link in the description. I make weekly tutorials on Inkscape and illustration, so if you're interested, I recommend you to subscribe and hit the bell. With that out of the way, let me show you my method to make organic shapes super easily. Let's start with the first ghost. Grab the pen tool and draw the rough shape of the ghost using straight lines. You can copy the location of my nodes if you want some similar results. Remember not to drag when you place a node. Resist the temptation to add a rounded section quite yet. Now switch to the node tool and adjust the position of the nodes so it looks closer to the shape you want, still maintaining the straight lines. In this case, I'm happy with the overall shape, so I won't adjust anything and move on to the next step, which is to add the curvature. So select all the nodes with the node tool. We don't want the tail to be rounded, so don't select that one, but all the others are fine for this. Then, with all the nodes selected, click on this button in the tool controls of the node tool. We just transformed these nodes to smooth type. Smooth nodes forces a smooth curvature through them, so now the shape looks closer to what we have in mind, but it is still not perfect. The next step is to move around these nodes and their handles to make the final shape you want. So with the node tool, do just that. Spend some good time moving the nodes and making the silhouette you want. You'll notice that moving around smooth nodes is way more limiting than moving around corner nodes with the straight sections, because when you move a smooth node, you also have to keep in mind the curvature and the handles. On the other hand, when you move around corner nodes, because there is no curvature, all the shapes connect perfectly without you having to touch anything. That's the main reason why you'd want to work in this two-step method, because making large shapes is really difficult when you have curvature. So always make sure to get as close as possible to the shape you want in the straight line step. Luckily here I didn't have to make too much changes. I was happy with the way everything came out, but you may need to spend a bit more time refining to get the exact shape you want. Continuing with the face, this is gonna be easy. Grab the ellipse tool and draw an ellipse on the face section. Using the palette, give it this black, the third one from the left. For the other eye, just select the eye shape and hit Ctrl D to duplicate it, and move it to the other side. The trick to make nice looking faces is to squash the other eye vertically and horizontally so it looks like it's in perspective. So use the object tool's arrows. Now to make the mouth. Grab the pen tool and draw this shape. This one we are not gonna smooth it, so draw it using the pen tool and adjust it so you get what you want. Remove the stroke and give it the same black than before. You may want to scale it horizontally to put it a bit more into perspective. Okay, the next step will be to make the arms. We're gonna follow the same process than before, grab the pen tool, and take a look at the shape I'm making. Once again, I'm using straight sections. It doesn't look that good now, so select all the nodes except the bottom two and smooth them. Now it looks better, but still not entirely correct. So with the node tool, move around the nodes so the silhouette looks nice and pleasant. For the other arm, there's no need to start from zero. Just duplicate the arm you have with Ctrl D and move it below. Using the object tool, put it into position. We could leave it like this, but I think having a perfect copy of a section of the body looks weird, so switch to the node tool and move the nodes around to make a variation of the shape, so it won't look exactly the same. Don't be afraid of deleting some nodes or changing some proportions as you're adjusting this new arm. We are done with the drawing. Now let's give it the color to the body. Just select all the three shapes. Remove the stroke and give it this white, the third white from the right. This almost looks right, but the top arm is on top of the body in the stack order. It should be below. You can change the stack order by selecting it and hitting these buttons over here. But I recommend you to memorize the shortcuts because that's an operation that you will have to do all the time. And we are done with the first ghost. The next one is going to be just a bit more complex, but not too much. Once again, start with the rough shape. And again, if you want to copy the placement of my nose, you can do that. But I always encourage you to play with these concepts and try new stuff on your own. Repeating the same steps, with the node tool, select all the nodes that are not going to be corners, which are these ones here at the bottom, and transform them to smooth type. And further repeating, with the node tool, adjust the node so it matches with the shape you had in mind. A nice tool to keep in mind here is that you can hold shift and drag from a corner node to pull out the handle, this way adding the curvature in a much more gentle way. Give it the white color from before. Okay, I'm happy with the main shape, but I think I want to add something to the silhouette. Maybe something like a tail, but in the head, to differentiate it from the one before. And rather than redrawing the entire thing, we're gonna draw this shape on top, and because we're gonna give it the exact same color, nobody will notice that are two separated shapes. So grab the pen tool and make this shape. Follow the exact same two-step process of drawing the shape with the straight lines and then smoothing them up. Select all the nodes, but not this one in the corner, and then go to the smooth type button. Adjust it to make it fit if you feel that needs it. Now for the arms. I want to do something different than before. This time I want some classic ghost arms, so with the pen tool, make this shape. Adjust if you need it, and when you're done, select all the nodes and make them smooth. Further adjust if you need. For the other arm, just duplicate it to the other side with Ctrl D. Use the object tool to rotate it and scale it so it looks as different as it makes sense to the original arm. And then, of course, keep changing further with the pen tool. Now for the face. We want a slightly more complex face. Again, nothing too different from before. He's gonna have an evil look. With the pen tool, make this triangle and remove the stroke and give it the same black from before. We don't want geometrical eyes for this character. Switch to the node tool and round off the bottom node. Here I'm using the shift drag method I talked about earlier. And bend a bit the top as well. Okay, now for the other eye. We don't have to do it all over again, we could reuse this one. Select with the object tool and hit Ctrl D, move it to the other side. We need to flip it. You can do that by hitting the H key. Now, if you remember from before, to make the other eye, we can always squash it horizontally to make it look like it's being distorted by perspective. It's something super easy to do and always looks super convincing. For the mouth, I want some sort of smirk, so make this shape, similar to the eye but a lot more squashed vertically. Repeat the exact same steps than before to round off the corners. And give it the right colors. You may want to adjust and refine a couple of things here, but for now, I think this is done for me. Let's move to the final ghost. Again, this is gonna be just slightly more complex, but not that much. The body is gonna be a bit more complex, so let's start with the base. Grab the ellipse tool and make an ellipse. Maybe squash it vertically a bit. If you need it, give it the white that we were using for the other ghosts. I don't want a perfect elliptical body. We could transform this shape to a pure path and modify the nodes, but to stick to the tools we've been using, let's just draw a shape here at the top. Grab the pen tool and make this shape on top of the ellipse. This is where the head is gonna be. Just like before, try to make it fit seamlessly with the rest of the body. Then transform the nodes into smooth and adjust. I'm thinking it could use a tail here at the head as the previous ghost, so grab the pen tool again and make this shape, like a hat on top of the head. Using the shift drag method of adding curvature, make it thicker like you see here. The arms are gonna be different than before. Grab the pen tool and make this simple shape. Round it off using the shift drag method. When you're done, duplicate it to the other side with Ctrl D, and then you flip it horizontally with the H key. Put it somewhere on the side and modify it a bit so it's not an exact copy. As a final detail to the body, I would like to also give it a tail. Just like before, with the pen tool make this shape. Smooth it with the shift drag method and adjust it so it fits nicely with the rest of the body, as always. For the face, we want something a bit more crazy. Grab the ellipse tool and draw one eye. Duplicate it to the other side. And this time, using the black arrows, scale it and rotate it so it looks completely different than the other one. For the mouth, grab the pen tool and make this triangle shape. Using the shift drag method, add the curvature, and then curve the top as well. I think some goofy teeth here will look nice, so with the pen tool, draw a few rectangles overlapping the mouth. Don't make them straight, draw all of them with an angle so it looks goofier. Because we didn't connect the teeth with the mouth, using, for example, a Boolean operation, we can adjust the position, we can even add more later on if we want. That's one of the great things when working with more simple designs like this. And I think we are done with all the ghosts. I hope you enjoyed this video, and maybe learn a couple of things on organic drawing in Inkscape. The truth is that I didn't have time to make something more complex, and I didn't want it to skip one upload. But I am thinking in starting to make tutorials with simple subjects. Though I would love to hear your feedback on what I should continue making in the channel. So don't forget to give this video a like and comment, and of course subscribing for more weekly Inkscape tutorials. That's it for now. See you next time. Bye.